Thank you for joining us for another ACDI technical training. This video is going to be the second in a series that goes over KPAX, a cloud-based print fleet management software. With every video in the series, we'll be going over each one of KPAX's key features. We'll also provide tips and tricks along the way and help you get the most benefit from this tool. On today's video, we're going to be going over the user section under settings. So let's get started. Once we've logged into KPAX and are on the landing page, we'll want to click on the settings button on the top right-hand side. The settings button is the one that has the cog icon. After you click on the icon, we'll have a pop-up menu that is broken down into three sections: users, administration, and documentation. As mentioned before, we're going to be focusing only on the user section. So coincidentally enough, the first option under user is user. So let's click on that. Now we're in the users management tab. On this page, it displays a list of our users. There's also a standard toolbar with the search field that will help you find a specified user. There's an action section on the toolbar that gives you the option to unselect or select all users, an add user button to add additional users, and lastly, there's also a drop-down menu that allows the user to navigate to the roles or user group management page. If we look at our list of usernames, we'll notice that there's four buttons to the right of each username, which are modify, switch to this account, send password reset link, and delete. Now, all of these buttons are pretty self-explanatory, except for the switch to this account button. This one allows you to actually navigate through the KPAX web interface as the user selected. That way, you can experience firsthand what that user is seeing. To go back to your regular user view, all you have to do is click on the unlink button that appears between the settings button and the language selection button. Now that we have a handle on this page, let's take a look at how to add a new user. First, we'll need to click on the blue Add a User button. This will direct us to a page that will require us to fill out information of the user that's being added, such as the last name, first name, and email address. Something else to take note of is the connection level setting. The connection level is extremely important. This will determine the accounts the user will have access to. For example, if you choose the root account as the connection level for the user, it will give them access to every single account under your KPAX instance. If instead you choose a sub-account, this will give the user access to only that sub-account and any accounts under it. Below the main section, there are also permission levels, which we'll go into more detail when we go over roles. Once you've filled out all the required information to create a user, this will allow you to click on the Validate button on the bottom of the screen. After that, the system will send an email to the user you just created. This will invite them to create a password for their KPAX account and log in for the first time. One more thing, before the administrator clicks on the Validate button, the administrator should have determined if this user should belong to either a user group or a specific role that has been created inside of the KPAX instance. Both of these options are what we're about to discuss next. So to navigate to the roles, I'm going to click on the settings button and then click on roles in the user section. Now that I'm in the roles page, it'll show us a list of roles that we can either delete or modify. Now before we configure a new role, let me briefly explain what they are. Roles are a set of predefined permissions that can be assigned to a user. So for example, if you have a group of text that you only want to allow to be able to view devices and agents, but not give access to any of the setting options, you're able to pre-configure all of those permissions ahead of time. That way, when you create a new user for a technician, you can just simply apply a role instead of needing to configure each permission manually. Now, to create a new role, let's start by clicking on the Add a Role button on the toolbar. Then, on this page, we'll need to fill in the name field to create an identifying name for the role. Then, we can choose the privileges that will be assigned to the role. And as you can see, there are quite a few permissions that could be granted to each user or role. So, an administrator can get very granular when deciding which permissions they want to grant. Once you are done choosing the permissions that you want to provide to this role, go ahead and click on the Validate button at the bottom to save the changes. So now that we've gone over roles and permissions, the last section that we will need to be going over is user groups. To get to the user groups management page, I'm once again going to click on the settings button and click on user groups under the user section. Now that I'm in the user groups management page, it will show us a list of user groups that we can either delete or modify. Now, user groups will allow an administrator to do bulk user actions for a predetermined set of users. So let's go ahead and create a user group. First, we'll need to click on the Add a Group button on the toolbar. Then, in the Create a New Group page, we'll need to fill in the name field to create an identifying name for the group. Next, we'll want to go ahead and choose a color that will help us identify the group within the KPAX portal. Once the color is selected, we'll want to select the users by clicking on the boxes next to the usernames. Once we've done all this, we can go ahead and click the Validate button to create a group. Now, there are going to be a few spots throughout the admin interface where the user group actions can be taken. So make sure to keep a lookout for those as we move along through this training series. And with that, we've covered the user settings inside of the KPAX administration portal. Should you ever have any questions or need assistance, please feel free to contact our ACDI support team.